Shadowkeep is around the corner, and as many of us have been eagerly waiting, myself included, I've been trying to use some different things, some different combos, different weapons to freshen up the game a little bit and do something different, change things up to be a little bit more exciting, and like I said, do something different. And one of those things has been going back to using double primary combos. As many of you guys may have seen, one of my previous videos was talking about the Mida combo. And unfortunately, it was a little bit more in a negative light because I think that combo has been incredibly power crept. Something that I didn't really elaborate on though is that there isn't actually much reason to be using double primary at all. When I would use a double primary combo like the Mida combo, I felt like it just became a somewhat frustrating experience because on face value, I think that the benefit of double primary is that it offers a bit more consistency at more ranges. So you get more range coverage and you probably have two pretty consistent weapons within the ranges. Whereas with special weapons, you have a weapon that performs at a more specific range but has a really high potential within that range. So for example, shotguns work within really close range, no farther usually than about 8 or 9 meters. However, they one hit within that range most of the time, or at least put down a lot of damage. Snipers can of course cover really far ranges, and of course a very good sniper can make it work at a lot of ranges, but is very very pinpoint accurate, and you need to be accurate in order to land your shot, so it's high risk high reward. And then of course fusions are able to have a little bit more mid-range coverage at the cost of having that charge time. So again, they all have more of a niche purpose, a little bit more risk to them, but they have very very high potential. Now even though on face value it feels like double primary might give you a little bit more consistency in each engagement range, giving up those one-hit kill weapons is actually really detrimental. Again, you're going to be missing out on a close, medium, or potentially long-range one-hit kill weapon that you could be using to complement or at least try and make up for the lack of whatever range you're losing out on with your main primary weapon. Now I do understand that there are a few outliers for double primaries. There's Recluse that can be used with another primary like Ace of Spades or whatever you'd like and is very very strong, and you have the Sturm and Drain combo which also is very strong, but these are strong because of some very high damage buffs. Yes, these are things that do allow the double primary combo with these weapons to be a little bit more viable and a little stronger, however I don't think the game should need to rely on a bunch of damage buffs to make things viable. I think Sturm und Drang has a very, very unique dynamic and a fun dynamic of gameplay which is really unique to them, which is awesome, but in Recluse's case, it really is just viable because of such an insane damage boost to both headshot and body shot damage doing the same damage after being active, and on top of that, it still, I think, gets more mileage out of being used in that way with special weapons. So yes, there are these two options, but I'd like to see all of double primaries just as a choice being more powerful rather than just these options because of crazy damage buffs. Special weapons right now are very powerful. There's quick draw shotguns that allow you to put up minimal damage with something like a hand cannon, then take out your shotgun and just clean up the kill, and you're earning yourself a farther one hit kill range because they already have a decent amount of damage in the target, which again will allow the shotgun to require less pellets to connect for a kill. 140 RPM snipers can double body, the revoker's a high impact that refunds bullets, and Beloved has a pretty big toolbox of powerful perks. So most snipers also have low zoom for more versatility, so there's a lot of really great snipers to be using right now. And on top of that, for fusions, there's high impact fusions that have pretty good range, cover that mid range, even a little bit further in some cases, and backup plant is also just insanely powerful, not having to deal with nearly as long charge time. We've also got to remember that most of these weapons fit within the majority of engagements on maps, like shotguns are nearly relevant on pretty much every single Destiny map, and missing out on that ability to one-shot targets in within that close range, that tight close range that most maps find you in, being able to one-shot or missing out on that ability or even just put in high damage is really, really costly. And the thing is, this high damage or one-shot kills actually create a lot of difficulty for the double primary combos, even if you're using something like an SMG or a sidearm in an attempt to counter shotguns. again, revisiting the Mida combo, for instance, hypothetically, and even when using it, it feels like a well-rounded weapon combination that effectively covers most ranges. You have a really reliable primary for long range and a really reliable secondary or SMG primary for close to mid-range, which is actually really nice. However, in actual practice, it gets shut down and struggles against shotguns and fusions, despite being a good combination of two weapons. An SMG in most close ranges cannot stop the power of a mid-range fusion rifle or even a shotgun that might not even kill, just a shotgun with quick draw that will just swap to a hand cannon cleanup. It's still very difficult to counter. So here are a few ideas that I have that could make double primary weapons as a loadout more reasonable and actually viable. The first one that I'm going to talk about is probably not going to be a favorite. You guys might not agree with me on this, but I think nerfing scavenger perks would actually make double primary a lot more viable, because currently there's an abundance of special ammo, and scavenger perks stacking to give more ammo per brick makes the effect of double primary not dropping any special on death pretty much insignificant, because you'll always have or usually have more ammo to pick up from other deaths or other pickups, including maybe even teammates. And because of the scavenger perks, they're most likely going to last you a few kills where you even don't get special ammo off of them. My next idea is, I think, a little less controversial, and I really like this. I really hope this actually happens in the game, and that's allow double primary users to pick up special ammo as primary ammo. So by doing this, you allow double primary users to have a way of preventing special users from gaining more ammo when they see it drop on the ground, effectively just eating it or burning the ammo. And of course, with less special ammo in play, double primary has a little bit more of a competitive edge. I don't know if this would be too strong, but perhaps for using double primary weapons or two primary weapons, you can grant a slight synergy bonus. Nothing lethal, but maybe something like a handling buff or reduced flinch, something of that nature to give a bonus to double primary that actually helps the consistency of the pairing and makes your primaries just feel a bit more consistent than they would if you weren't using two primaries. Lastly, I think this should increase the damage output of double primary weapons against supers, because currently, using double primary means you're giving up the potential to shut down supers or deal high damage against supers that will of course result in them being shut down, which is incredibly important. Shutting down a super is very pivotal to a game, and you don't want to lock yourself out of being able to do that. But right now, it's not really viable to shut down a super or put in any sort of real significant damage like you would with a sniper or a shotgun with double primary against a super, and of course that's really disadvantageous. So those are just a few ideas that I had to make double primaries a little bit more viable. I think just a few of these, all of these of course would be phenomenal, but even just a few of these being done to double primaries could give them an actual reason to be used and make them more competitive. Right now, as though it feels like we have choice, I think it's just an illusion of choice, simply because a primary and a special being used together is simply way stronger than using two primaries. In fact, I actually think, at least in quick play, which is I think the majority of what people play, double special is actually better in most cases, or nearly every case, than double primary. I actually use double special pretty frequently, and I do much better than I could do using double primary. And sure, while you could argue, yeah, SMGs and sidearms kind of do a decent job against baiting shotguns, the thing is, at a top level, especially like I said, with quick draw shotguns existing, that high damage output is still going to counter you, is still going to kill you, and why put yourself through that kind of challenge or sort of decision to try and have an uphill battle for a decent counter when there's actually not much reason to be doing that? If there was some sort of reason, if there's some sort of counter, some sort of thing that makes you better or hurts the enemy by using double primary, perhaps there'd be a reason to take that little bit of a uphill battle challenge against shotguns with an SMG or with a sidearm, something like that. But right now, there just really isn't. not dropping special ammo is not significant in most cases, and pretty much any case, I want to say. Anyway, since I've been fooling around with weapons, this is something that I really noticed. Like I said, using the Mida combo or double primary combos in general turned from a nice idea that seemed kind of fun on paper to a more frustrating experience, and I just hope in the future there's more viability or more reason to be using double primary at least. It doesn't have to be meta, just a nice kind of anti-meta option with a little bit of perks to it. Anyways, hope you guys enjoyed the video. I'll see you guys in the next one. Take care.